they want to adapt to one team already.
Oh.
That is already a big plus. Now we can just augment that by looking for the sponsor to help in the expenses. But we are open for them to join the other races. We will support them. Even in international races down the line, makakatulong din kami.
So ito, kabalik na rin ito ng mga other previous races nga na nabanggit natin, no? Di ba? Dahil yung ating mga nauna noon, gusto nila exclusive. Pagka dito ka, hindi ka na pwedeng sumali sa iba. So that's one big difference ng Ronda Pilipinas. But
yes, that's definitely one of the biggest. Kasi we want to develop cycling. Uh-huh. And to develop cycling, kailangan talaga more competition. The more the competition, the better the cyclists can become. And then, the better they can develop into a team that can be internationally accredited and be able to be competitive, no? Another point also is we're putting roughly about 7 million pesos in prizes.
Ganun kalaki.
So this is, I think, one of top 5 or 7 biggest prize pool for cycling in the world already. So there's 1 million that is going to the top individual rider and 1 million to the top team. So napakalaking halaga yan para talagang lumaban sila sa race, no?
Oo, 1 million siguro. Baka yung, kumbaga, Giselle, yung the best of the best na mga riders na siguro sa iba, sa Pilipinas, sasali na sigurado dito.
Oo, kasi yung bukod dun sa 1 million na yon, yung second place para sa individual, makakatanggap ng 500,000. Yung third place, 250,000.
Oo.
Hindi dyan nagtatapos, usually for second, third lang, no?
Oo.
Hanggang 10th, yung 4th place, 125,000, yung 5th, 100,000, and then yung 6th, 90,000, 7th, 80,000, yung 9th, 60,000, at yung 10th, 50. Tapos yung 11th to 15th, makakatanggap ng 10,000 each, at yung 16th to 20th, makaka-receive naman ng tigli 5,000. So talagang medyo for an individual prize, medyo talagang malaki to. At sa kada team price naman, ganun din yung hatian.
Oh.
Yung second, magkakaroon ng 500,000. Yung third, 250. Yung fourth, 100. At yung sixth, 90,000.
Oh.
So talagang binibigyan natin ng opportunity ang Pilipinong siklista na talagang mainganyo at pagbutihin ang pagsali sa Ronda Pilipinas.
At saka yung sa stage finish rin, may mga prizes yung stage finish.
This so mag-finish ka lang, may prize ka na.
Meron na, may mga strategies kami ginawa sa prize pooling.
Oh.
Kasi kinuha namin si Mr. Jamal Mahmood, no? Former UCI Asia head. Siya yung pag-consultant ng Ronda Pilipinas. At meron may parang strategy rin ang pag-breakdown ng mga pera.
Oh.
So that way, kahit na may isang grupo o isang racer na makahiwalay, hahabulin talaga ng second place yan dahil malaki yung prize na hinahabol nila on a per stage basis.
So, ganun ko importante. Right now, siguro, ang daming mga nakikinig sa atin na tuwan-tuwa dito sa balita. Ito, siguro, tatanong ko kayo mo, paano ba sasali dito? Sigurado, buong Pilipinas nakikinig sa atin, paano ba sasali dyan sa Ronda Pilipinas niyan? 1 million ang papremyo.
Yes, well, we have application forms that are available in any LBC branch. We also have application forms that you can get from the website. That's www.rondapilipinas.com. You can also follow us on Facebook. And then I would also like to touch base, no, and to discuss with you some points of the race.
Oh.
Because, you know, this is really a big race and I will go to the stages of the race, if it's okay with you.
Yes, Rose, sandali lang. Sisingit ko lang yung Rudy Project.
Oh, yes.
So available din yung application form sa lahat ng Rudy Project branches or stores nationwide.
So pwede silang pumunta sila doon, may mga application form
na doon. Naka-ready lahat 'yon. Partner namin 'yan.
Okay, Mo.
Okay, with regards to the race itself, no? We're doing 12 stages. This will be from September towards October, no? We will start off with a prologue in Mall of Asia. And then now the whole race will go to Cagayan de Oro and do a Cagayan de Oro Bukidnon to Cagayan de Oro leg. From there, we will ferry to Dumaguete, where we will do a Dumaguete to Bacolod leg. And then from there, ferry to Iloilo. From Iloilo, we'll go to Katiklan.
Oh.
When we end in Katiklan, it will be the culmination of the Mindanao and the Visayas leg.
Oh.
So we will do a Linis Dagat project in Boracay because there is a Go Green advocacy behind this.
Oh, yun, tatanong ko. Unprecedented,
like I said, unprecedented tong race. There's no race that has ever gone to Boracay, but we will take them to Boracay. And from there, we will go from Calapan, Mindoro to Puerto Galera. From Puerto Galera, it's a ferry to Batangas. From Batangas to Tagaytay. From Tagaytay, we caravan to Quezon City. From Quezon City, we go to Tarlac. From Tarlac, we go to La Union. From La Union, we go to Vigan. From Vigan to Baguio. And then we dump another stage in Baguio. And then from Baguio to Angeles. And then Angeles to Manila via EDSA, ending in kilometer zero in Rojas Boulevard.
Sayang, di tayo nagkausap agad. Di kayo nagdanang antipolo, no? Baka pabit mo. Kanina na, sir, mo, sa Boracay, meron kayong cleaning project because you're going to go green. Ano ba ito?
Yes. There's a whole advocacy behind this. No, it's a go green advocacy. So, aside from just the race itself, LBC has a main project on this part, which is Go Green. Can I request Javi to...
LBC has been in the business here for 60 years in the Philippines already.
Ganun na katagal, ha?
And every year, dahil sa courier products namin, we have to use plastic receptacles. And we've been looking at different ways on how we can help the environment. So we put up 3 programs. One, yung lahat ng mga plastic receptacles namin, naka-coat siya ng biodegradable component. So basically, nangyayari is after 6 months, nagde-disintegrate, nagbe-breakdown yung plastic into something that's safe for the environment. And then, we have the Linis Dagat program. This Linis Dagat program, we collect hard plastics from the seashores. And then we put up a melting facility where all these plastics are melted into different molds that we create. Dati nagkakreate kami ng shells. So, ginagamit ng LBC to sa lahat ng mga branches niya to make the shells.
Reuse din, no?
Yes, so, lahat ng melted plastic, ilang tonelada ng kinuha namin mula sa mga dagat at minemelt namin para gawin shells. Now, we're trying to work with the LGUs to create like flooring so they can use for their public schools and to use for school, for any type of flooring sa mga eskwelahan or sa mga community nila.
Oh, that is a unique effort. Ano? Saan yun ako yung idea nito, yung boss ninyo nakaisip, si Dino Araneta?
Yes, Mr. Araneta is one of the main proponents here. No, we also have Mr. Chris Guidotti, who was one of his projects really to look into different ways that LBC can enter into these things. We know many companies that are doing their own advocacies, and we didn't want to duplicate. We wanted to find something that was, you know, unique to LBC and something that we could sustain with the community, no? So, yan yung isang malaking project, yung Linis Dagat. The other one also, yung hindi ko sinabi, is, we will start also with LBC. We will be looking at moving some of our fleet into electric.
So from gasoline.
From
so
gasoline or now, diesel to electric. And we will showcase 1 or 2 or maybe even 3 of these motorcycles dito sa Ronda, Pilipinas. Sila yung magiging parang
escort.
Escort namin na we are starting the program to see what we can do for the environment. Alam mo naman, sa negosyo namin, parati kami nasa kalsada eh. Diba? So we need to make sure that the roads are, the environment is good and clean so that way we can continue to do our deliveries well.
I nakadinig na ako ng mga electric cars eh, but this is the first time na madidinig ko electric motorcycle.
These are, sa Europe, malakas to. Most of the post offices and all of that have gone to electric motorcycles. So we're looking at working with them and try to see a supplier that we can create our own. Kasi syempre, the Philippines and our architecture here sa Philippines, iba rin, no? So we want to make sure applicable siya sa mga kalsada natin.
Giselle?
Yung hindi lang yung advocacy ng LBC Ronda Pilipinas. So bukod doon, pinopromote din ito yung tinatawag na sports tourism. So kung makikita mo, lahat ng dadaanan ng Ronda ay may magagandang tanawin na pinopromote yung local tourism natin. Siyempre kasama yung coverage at media exposure, mapapansin yung mga yan.
Yung sa mga lugar na, kumbaga tourist destination, mas maka-highlight pag dinala nyo dun yung Ronda Pilipinas.
Yung electric car na sinasabi kanina, iha-highlight ito dun sa tinatawag na kick-off activity namin. Isang linggo bago yung totoong karera ng Ronda Pilipinas. Doon, kapag umabot ng 1,000 by May 15, yung Facebook page namin, yung facebook.com/rondapilipinas, kapag umabot ng 1,000 by May 15, magkakaroon kami tinatawag na mass ride to kick off the event. Kasama yung mga electric motorcycle na ito. Tinatarget namin ito sa MOA. So, lahat ito magiging open ito sa lahat ng mga may bisikletang gustong